As soon as I have something to say that's not jovial, the fucking internet connection cuts out. I just want to back into the fucking, you know, make sure to fuck up the lyrics. Oh, it's working. Here we go. So what I was going to say was, yeah, I'm super duper annoyed. I've been treated like a piece of human garbage by none other than Tesla. I'd already been treated like a piece of human garbage by the fucking psychiatric hospitals and the Gardaí also. Predates 2010. But I'm super duper fucking pissed off because I cannot fucking stand how they fucking treated me when I did nothing other than to attempt to be a fucking stand-up fucking citizen. I was training with the civil defense for like 6 months before I had my mental breakdown. One reason was that I only found out who they were and where they were while I was pregnant. And I knew it in my own heart that it was the wrong fucking time. And I joined them when my son was over the age of one. When Phylum was over the age of one. And I, but I knew in my heart because I didn't go for the there's three different types of workers, and one of them is like you set up chairs and you give tea and coffee if there's a crisis situation, you hand it off, if there's an emergency situation and everyone has to come into has to shelter in one place and you sort them out, you know. That's one element, but I went for the fucking whole hog. I went for the one that involves like when you're qualified that you end up dangling 500 fucking meters from a helicopter rescuing someone from a cliff edge or the sea or something like that. The one where your life is literally at stake. Otherwise, you could be up the mountains searching for a missing person. I only found out later that they also have to do that to fucking find dead bodies, like up in the Wicklow Mountains. And if there happened to be like a building collapsed or there was an explosion or something, you will be the one in there to go in and dig out the people that are still in the building. So that's what I was training for. And I was doing this a good six months before the shit hit the fan. And in the back of my mind, I was highly fucking concerned that I had a small baby. And if I actually fucking do this, that there was a possibility that I could lose my life trying to save someone else's. And there was a conflict that I didn't want to fucking die because I have a little baby to like that would be left without a mother in that case. In the case it was Phylon. So I'm highly pissed off because I end up getting treated like a piece of human garbage by at the time it was HSE, there was no Tesla, there was no independent body, it was part of the health service. I got end up treating like a piece of shit by Tesla, and as if I had no, and then I ended up and it could have been as simple as a typo, like that because the social worker that came in to the case that is now looking is involved with my family only came into the scene. I was only employed after we'd already gone through 2 years of court hearings. And I am utterly fucking revolted at the way I was treated. And the entire court hearing, because it ended up, everything came out on the last day. And the fucking psychiatrist that had admitted me told the judge that I walked into the hospital of my own free will. And therefore, he decided that I had just chosen to leave Whalen and just walk into a hospital to have a little holiday or something where, you know, I think I'd rather been in Mallorca, you know, frankly. But, she wasn't fucking there that day. She was off for the weekend. She wasn't a witness, but this is what she testified, that I walked in of my own free will. What she doesn't know was that I was out of my mind completely. I didn't have a clue. I had completely lost my mind, and I had no comprehension of where I was or what was going on. And my mother had brought me in there. I didn't fucking know where I was. And it wasn't until she left that I fucking knew what happened. So anyway, basically, I'm massively fucking pissed off about the whole situation. And even though, like, now, and they fucking managed to fucking, somehow, I end up being put on this thing as if I had been an alco fucking mother that had neglected her child, when that was absolutely not the case. When I had the nervous breakdown, Phelan was with my mother, and he wasn't with me when it happened. So, yeah, anyway, hate to divulge, I'm on the truth serum, I'm really pissed off. This has gone on a decade, they're a disgrace, they're after ruining fucking a decade of me and Phelan's lives. My mother broke the law 3 fucking times, and there has been no fucking, like, it didn't even fucking come up, you know, that she took him out of the country without my consent. She got him baptized without my consent, gave him godmothers that didn't, like, that, like, that I didn't choose, and then she fucking got parents that I didn't choose, and she fucking, he had 15 febrile convulsions, and was in hospital 7 times, and I was not informed until after all of that had happened. And I was walking into court. I got to read it in a report from the fucking social workers. And then, just to make fucking matters worse, 3 of my friends, nobody I knew, had died in like 3 years. And then out of fucking nowhere, 3 people, all like in the same age range as me, died in the space of 6 months that I was fairly fucking close to, or at least fond of. One person I'd known since I moved to Malahide. Another one was an ex-boyfriend. I just hadn't seen him in a year. And the other one was my brother's wife. And she was lovely. When Phelan was born, she gave us a CD of Bob Marley's lullabies, Bob Marley lullabies, which is beautiful. It's all done on the glockenspiel and stuff, versions of Bob Marley, like, and this all fucking happened in the space of 6 months. But the only one they heard about was obviously Clarissa, my brother's wife, who died of an asthma attack in Brazil. So they knew about that one, but I didn't even tell them about the other fucking 2, and I didn't get a fucking chance to mourn any of these people dying, because I was too busy in a fucking custodial fucking hearing after I'd had a mental breakdown. I was in court after I had a fucking mental breakdown, like, and they acted as if this was fucking normal, like, you know, instead of, like, you know, just giving it due process or something. There was no kind of gauge, and nobody informed me of what my fucking rights actually are. So anyway. Yeah. So anyway. I'm very pissed off, but they basically, it's 10 years later. They're after fucking, they're after fucking interfering with Toby. On top of it, I had the social worker lying to her bosses about me. Literally lying to her bosses about me. I had her dicking me around. I'd ask her something. bit personal, and she fucking would say, oh, I'll get to it in a few months, and then she never mentioned it, and then I came back to it, and then she wouldn't, she said, oh no, sorry, oh I forgot you said that. And then she, and then fucking 9 months later, I'd ask her again, and she turns around and says, oh no, like oh no, that's not my job. Like she spent she dicked me around for a full fucking year. Then she li and then she lied to her fucking bosses on numerous occasions. And she's a fucking disgrace to the fucking to her fucking position. Like she's not be in the fucking role if she can't be upright, you know? So anyway, I'm disgusted. Anyway, I wasn't planning on going on an. I was only planning to go on a little tirade. I wasn't planning to go give you the whole fucking thing, and that's even fucking close the whole thing. But fuck it. Anyway, here we go. Ruth Casey sings along. They're disgraceful. What can I fucking say? They're a fucking disgrace. Holding on to when everything seems to matter more. The two of us, oh you, and being up watching things as it goes down the path we have chosen. You and me, we're in this together now. None of them can stop us now. We can make it through somehow. You and me, if the world should break in two, until the very end of me. Awake to the sound as they peel apart the skin. They pick and they pull, trying to get the fingers in. Well, they do what they thought. Well, they gotta hit what they feel. Well, they gotta make it go away. Well, they gotta make it disappear. The further I fall down beside you, as lost as I get, I will find you. The deeper the wound I'm inside you, forever and ever I am a part of you and me. We're in this together now. Nothing else will stop us now. We will make it through somehow. You and me, if the world should break in two, until until the very end of May. Until the very end of Yeah, anyway, I thought fucking screaming a song out would be more therapeutic than a fucking, just a random tirade of verbal shite.